and hope everybody's doing well. Happy holidays to you. And we're going to do a quick walkthrough and setup of VARHF and VARAC using EESDR version 3, alpha release 0.11.0, build number 3012-2021. And we're also going to use a new application written by EESDR that's called RigSync. RigSync allows you to basically emulate a TS-480 and also import and export audio over virtual audio cable back to TCI. So V3, that's going to be how you get your virtual audio cable going in here. So we'll kind of go through that real quick as well. So first thing you're going to need to do is grab your newest version of V3 from the EESDR website. And if you're watching this video, you probably already know how to get to that, so no big deal. And you're also going to want to grab the RigSync application that's posted there as well. I'll put links to that, both those in the description, along with links for VARHF and the VARAC. So once you get, already got that running. Let's bring it up. Sorry. Once you download RigSync, you're going to want to set your local host, which will be the same local host that you're using in TCI. So in my case, I set this to TCI port 40001, same as it is in V2, which makes all my applications that are using TCI compatible with each other, switching between V2 and V3. You can set these up for receiver 1, receiver 2. When you first do this, you'll give it a name. If I turn this off, now we're going to lose some audio settings, so I don't want to do that. But you can, I've named this one VARA. Again, it emulates the TS-480. And then you can do your sound card inputs and outputs, RX, TX, and then your sample rates. So we're going to leave that guy running. Next thing we're going to do is go into, make sure you do have TCI enabled once you start that. It's got to be able to talk back to the transceiver control interface, the TCI module. So basically set up of VARAC. Go ahead and launch this guy. I do have a monitor running as well as the actual application. Yeah, good, there's somebody in here. Okay, so underneath settings, you're going to set your sound card up. I'm using virtual audio cable 1 for my input and 2 for my output. And if you click the tune button here, it will go into transmit and you can adjust the level control. You'll see this when it goes into transmit, it's going to say TCI up here now instead of mic 2. So make sure you're using version 4.5.0 for VARAC, the chat module. The current version of that is 2.7.2. So that and your VAR setup, if you've got a registration key, you're going to want to put that in here and do close. You don't actually need the registration key. Registration key, if you have a license, will allow you to use greater bandwidth than 500. VARAC, by nature, pretty much everything is done at the 500 bandwidth. So you don't really need it. You will get a neg screen that pops up asking you about registering. Just kind of slide it off or close it, whatever you want to do. I would encourage you to upgrade it, though. You might find other features in some of the other applications, WinLink and I don't know, maybe a few other things that may come in handy for that. The next setting you'll need to do is in AC itself. So I'm going to use OmniRig. OmniRig is going to talk to my RigSync here. So my first port number, actually I'm using it backwards here. The second port number is 21, which I've got in RigSync, and in OmniRig. Let me pull up OmniRig real quick here. So in OmniRig, I'm using port 20, and yes, I'm emulating the TS-480 the same as it is here. And I've got my baud rate set as high as it'll go. My data bits, all that's going to match here. One thing to note here is the polling initiation time. By default, this is 100 milliseconds. Through a few configurations and some playing around, we found through some testing that probably a good thing to raise this up some. You don't want this to keep initializing and pulling the rig every 100 milliseconds. You may run into some issues where it's doing that and causing some problems with transmit and receive timings. So bump that up. The timeout, you can bump down to 100 milliseconds. I think some of the guys are using 500 for this, but I bumped it up a little higher than that. 500 is probably a good number to start with. So that's what's going to do my, let me minimize this, my frequency switching here for me. If I, whoop. So I've got that on rig one. If I click this, I should be able to change my frequencies then. Up there, you'll see that changed. And you can edit these in the, there's a write list you can edit for your frequencies. That's all on the, if you go to the VARAC forum on Facebook, you'll find that information there. There's some links there, and there's also on the actual form itself. If you go to the form in here, you'll find some information about that. So the other thing, let's see, the rest of this is just pretty much your canned messages, you know, what you want to send back and forth. So basically, this is how I got it to work with TCI and VAC, and you'll see that the monitor window is up now. See if Gary gets done with somebody here. We'll try to call him real quick for a test. So I'm not here in the other station. He's actually working. Actually, what am I on? Okay, I'm on 40. I was going to say. Might be why. I am on the beam, though, too. Let me actually go over to the dipole. I do have the other station in there now. And there. See my auto AGC has bumped the spectrum view down here some. This sounds like a slow contact. I got some noise going in the background here, too. It's been coming and going all day. Actually, you know what? You can see that it's reading and decoding, so let's just slide up a little bit. I'll go up here and we'll call CQ. When I go into transmit here, you'll see that the mic changes to TCI. Well, there you go, TCI. And you've got your power output. And again, you're gonna set your somebody else down further. You're gonna set your go into sound card settings here, you can set your drive level here. For your output. There's nobody up here. It's just Gary and them guys down below. Let's move back down. Actually, we can try 20 meters. Let me get on the right antenna for 20. You're going to want to be in digital upper, too, for this, by the way. If I didn't mention that before. Send out another CQ and see what happens here. Twenty's been kind of flat all day, though, so not really expecting too much here. You know, I just realized you guys are probably getting blasted when this thing goes into transmit mode, aren't you? Sorry. I apologize. I didn't think about that when it goes in the transmit because I'm dumping the audio back out over virtual audio cable up here and recording. All right. Nothing here. Let's go back to 40. I was hoping to make a contact real quick, but to wait till we get another sync lock on these guys. There we go. Looks like they're getting ready to sign. We'll try calling Gary real quick. I haven't heard an ID. Yeah, there's still somebody there. There we go. And there's the other one. All right, so we'll call Gary and see what happens here real quick. And hopefully we're connected. There we go. Typing back, so we'll see what happens here. Oh, he was wanting to QSY up, so let's QSY up. We should get reconnect here in a second. Well, where do you go? Stop stalking me. come on, Gary, where are you? We got more than one person in here, that's why. And we got... Let's do a disconnect and we'll connect to him again. think we got screwed up when we QS wide. There we go.
Can't type.
Oh. Yep, we do have some quorumers in here. Let's go ahead and sign it from him. I don't want to keep him from working somebody else right now. So that's kind of how this set up and how this works here real quick. So let's see if he's got something to say before we disconnect here. There he goes. So there you have it. It does work with... Wait for that to stop. I do have it working, again, with version 3 of EESDR, VAC. I am using version 4.65, the full registered version of virtual audio cable. And again, it's all kind of tied together with RigSync here. So, RigSync and the new V3 for EESDR is available on the EESDR site, and I'll put links to those in there, as well as links to VARA-HF and to the VARA-AC. 7:30, guys. Take care.